We are continuing our study of the situation in Camp Ashraf, and joining us by video conference from Paris is Maryam Rajavi from the National Council of Resistance of Iran. Ms. Rajavi, I invite you to begin your testimony. Following your testimony, we will have questions from the members of the committee. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, distinguished members, good day. I would like to thank you for your attention to the ongoing human rights violation in Iran, as well as the humanitarian crisis in Camp Liberty. I also want to express my deep appreciation for all your efforts during Iran Accountability Week. Such efforts, as you said, sounds the alarm on the fourfold Iranian regime threat, which are nuclear, terrorism, incitement, and in particular, the regime's widespread and systematic violations of human rights. The situation in Camp Liberty is directly linked to the political crisis in Iran. Indeed, what is happening in Camp Liberty is the other side of the coin of suppression in Iran. Since the US handed over the security of Camp Ashraf to the Iraqi government, in three attacks on Ashraf and three deadly missile attacks on Liberty, 116 residents have been killed by Iraqi forces and 1,350 have been injured and seven are still held as hostage. It is now 8 months that they are held hostage. 20 residents have also lost their lives due to medical blockade. Many years of medical blockade continue to affect even those who have left Iraq. Razi Kermanshahi died yesterday in Albania because for many years she had not received the proper medical care. And Muhammad Babai passed away in Liberty on April 27 for lack of medical care. So far, as the PMI members are concerned, they are paying the price for their perseverance for freedom of the Iranian people. The religious fascism ruling Iran, engulfed by political, economic, and international crisis, considers PMI as the most serious threat to its rule. The PMI is seen as the major force for change in Iran. Therefore, the regime will not spare an opportunity to strike at this organization. For this reason, Liberty residents have become the prime targets of the regime's atrocities. I would like to address three aspects of the situation in Liberty, which are very important. Security situation, living condition, and resettlement of the residents outside Iraq. The prime issue is lack of security in face of missile attacks on Camp Liberty. Trailers are overcrowded with no protective walls or bunkers for residents to take shelter at the time of missile attacks. They are completely defenseless and vulnerable. Iraq's internal conflict and worsening security situation have increased the danger for the residents. Remarks by Iraqi Minister of Justice on March 2nd and Iraq's ambassador in Tehran on April 27 regarding extradition of PMOI members in Liberty is another indication of the dangerous situation of the residents. The second issue is the living condition in Camp Liberty. Human rights of residents are being systematically violated. UN Working Group on Arbitrary Detention in two reports have described Camp Liberty as a prison. Residents have no freedom of movement, denied the right to have family visits or meet their lawyers, and are under medical blockade. The Iraqi government is also trying to steal residents' properties left at Camp Ashraf and has so far prevented them from selling their properties. Third issue is the resettlement of the residents. After 2.5 years since the residents started relocation from Ashraf to Camp Liberty, only 10% of the 3,200 residents have been resettled outside Iraq, and prospect for resettlement of the others looks dim, while all residents have been interviewed by UNHCR. The question is what to do now. One, the first step is an independent international investigation into the killings, in particular the massacre of 52 residents and abduction of 7 on September 1st, 2013. These are the photo of 52% who have been massacred in September 1st in Ashraf. And had there been an independent investigation about the first massacre and had its perpetrators been brought to justice, we would not have seen the following massacres. Such investigation would be a preventive measure. Therefore, I urge you and the International Human Rights Committee to call on the government of Canada to initiate such an investigation by a relevant international authority. Two, the international community must provide security for the residents so long as they are in Camp Liberty by stationing international observers and a unit of blue helmets in the camp, by offering financial and logistical support for such an initiative, the government of Canada can remove all obstacles and excuses. And three, violation of the residents' human rights is part of the ongoing human rights violations in Iran. Families of the 3,000 Liberty residents in Iran are also suffering, as many of them have been arrested, abused, some executed, and a number of them are on death row. This matter must be addressed at the UN Security Council. And I call on the Canadian government to raise this matter in the third committee of the UN. Four, finally, the government of Canada can play an active role in the relocation of the residents by accepting a group of refugees from Camp Liberty and encourage countries to take more refugees. In the end, I would like to thank the government of Canada and the Parliament for the firm position towards the Iranian regime. In recent years, the government cutting off diplomatic ties with the Mullah's regime and parliamentarian support for the Iranian resistance have been heartwarming for our people in their efforts to achieve freedom. The regime has intensified suppression because it feels more vulnerable. Despite claims of moderation by the regime's president, there have been more executions over the past year compared with any other year in the past 25 years. Last month, political prisoners in the Evin prison were brutally attacked by prison guards. The mullahs have intensified their attacks on Ashraf and Liberty. And in such circumstances, Canada's support for human rights in Iran, freedom, and Iranian resistance is more effective than any other time. Our objective is a free and democratic Iran, a republic based on separation of religion and state, gender equality, and rule of law. A new Iran with no discrimination against religious or ethnic minorities, and a non-nuclear Iran. I thank you for your attention and would like to hear your views. Thank you very much.